What affects a game's installed capacity a lot is not only the visual resources but also the sound. Sound work is often the last thing in game development. As such, it is recognized as a task of low importance, and the task may be neglected. In addition, if you proceed without basic knowledge in the field for sound work, it will result in a sudden increase in capacity during build as well as poor optimization of the game. In today's video, I will show you how to use sound files optimized for the game development. Before we go into how to use sound files in Unity, it seems like a brief understanding of sound files is needed. To play sound on your computer, you need a sound file stored in digital form. These sound files can be directly recorded or created through a program, but today's explanation will take the recording as an example. Let's find out how sounds or music are stored on your computer. Everything a human can hear is an analog signal. On the other hand, other electronic devices, including computers, use digital data made up of zeros and ones. So how do you convert analog signals to digital? The first step in recording is to input the sound signal. A microphone is used for input. The signal input through the microphone goes through a process called sampling in the computer. Sampling refers to the operation of taking samples of the high frequencies from the low frequencies contained in the sound. To explain it easily, it can be said that the work is done to distinguish between low-pitched sounds such as bass, and high-pitched sounds such as trumpets. The size of the samples thus obtained must be converted into a digital quantity, which is called quantization. Now the quantized samples are ready to be converted to a digital signal. By processing each sample in binary, you can finally save the sound to your computer. As the frequency range for sampling acquisition increases, more bits are required. The higher the sampling rate, the wider range of frequencies can be handled. You can get better sound quality, but as much information needs to be stored, the file size increases. This process is collectively referred to as PCM, or pulse code modulation. The audible frequency band that adults can hear is known to be between 20 and 20,000 Hz. However, recording and sampling are processed in a frequency band that is more than twice as wide. The sound file recorded in this way contains information of a wide frequency band. The sound quality is excellent, but the file size is very large. Especially in the case of BGM, it is impossible to use it immediately when making a game. Therefore, to reduce the file size, frequency bands that are difficult for adults to hear are deleted and saved. This is called lossy compression. MP3 files that you know are a typical lossy compression format. There are various audio file formats supported by Unity, but when added to a Unity project, the format is automatically changed to Vorbis format. Even though MP3 files were used, it was confirmed that the file size was reduced when using the Vorbis compression format. Let's look at each of the options for an audio clip. Forced to mono literally means turning stereo sound into mono. It is unchecked by default, but in fact it should be applied to the overall sound effect or voice. When using this option, only one channel is used, so there is a significant advantage in reducing the file size. Therefore, it is recommended to turn this option on for all sounds except BGM, except in special cases. Normalize is checked by default in Unity, and the volume of the audio source is changed to a unique setting value of Unity. In particular, the volume of the sound recorded or produced in high decibels is changed to the average volume. If you use the load and background option, the sound file is loaded when the game or scene starts. This is a kind of asynchronous loading, and sound playback is possible after the file is loaded. Since there is a delay time due to loading, it is suitable for sound effects or BGM, which do not require precise timing. So, let's turn off this option for sound effects tailored to the timing, such as clock sounds and footsteps. The ambisonic option makes the audio source suitable for 360-degree environments like VR. Now let's look at the audio source type setting. Load type provides three modes. Decompress on load is a method of decompressing a sound file and storing it in memory. This method has the advantage of less delay due to decoding when playing sound. On the other hand, it has the disadvantage of high memory usage. So, this mode is suitable for accurate and frequently used sound effects, such as knife bumps and footsteps. And it is recommended to use PCM, which is an uncompressed format regardless of decompression. Compressed in memory is stored in the memory in a compressed state, and decompressed when playing. This mode is suitable for long sound effects that you use often. 80 PCM is recommended to avoid delays in playback, otherwise Vorbis is recommended. Streaming plays sounds instantly from storage without using any memory. This is suitable for large files such as BGM. The preload audio data option is a feature that preloads the sound file when the scene is loaded. If unchecked, sound files must be manually loaded in the specific scene. This has the advantage of reducing memory usage and the load time of individual scenes. Note that you must unload the sound files that have already been loaded before loading other scenes to avoid running out of memory later. Compression format supports three types. PCM was explained earlier, so I will skip the explanation. The Vorbis format is a free open-source audio codec created by XIPH organization. Like MP3, it is a lossy compression format that eliminates audio bands that are difficult for adults to hear. The advantage is that the file size is smaller than MP3 and the sound quality is excellent. However, due to the high compression rate, the CPU usage required for decoding is higher than MP3. If you select Vorbis, you can adjust the file size through the quality option. 80 PCM is a method of sampling the sound source at 4-bit, which is half of that of PCM. File size can be reduced while there is little difference from PCM sound quality. In addition, since it does not consume a lot of CPU resources required for decoding, it is suitable for long sound effects such as explosion sounds. The sample rate setting provides three options to set the amplitude of samples per second of the sound source. Preserve sample rate is an option that uses the sample rate of the sound source as it is. When you select Optimize Sample Rate, Unity will automatically analyze the audio file and adjust the sample rate. The Override Sample Rate option allows the user to manually set the sample rate for the audio source. When Override Sample Rate is selected, 44 kHz is set as the default, which is used for high-quality sound sources at the standard compact disc level. The smaller the sample rate, the dull sound is produced, but the file size can be reduced by that amount. Conversely, there are more steps to sample in 1 second, resulting in a larger file size. When making a mobile game, the sampling rate of BGM is enough to be 44 kHz. It is recommended to set the sound effect between 8 kHz and 22 kHz depending on the scene. For example, the sound quality of 8 kHz is effective for the voice you hear when using a telephone or walkie-talkie. In the case of 11 kHz, it would be suitable for sound effects in the low frequency range. 22 kHz seems to be suitable for most UI sound effects. Sound is one of the essential elements in gameplay. The playing of the sound effect is a factor that is more helpful for the user's interaction, and the BGM can create the atmosphere of the game. However, if you work without basic knowledge about sound, you will face a number of problems. Depending on the situation and use of the game, proper sound settings are essential, which is directly related to game optimization. Although the weight may be less than the management of graphic resources, please do not forget that the sound setting is also an important factor in the optimization of the game. That's all for today's video. Thank you. See you next time.